Hello, YouTube, and welcome back into another Dare to Game video. Today we're playing Valheim, and we're bringing you top 6 food items. So this is going to be a ranking based on what are just the most useful food items to cook and use in this game. And it'll be based off a variety of things: how much health they add, how much stamina they add, how long do they last, what kind of healing do they benefit, all that sort of stuff. So we're going to be going 6 to 1, 6 being the worst, 1 being the best. But mind you, all of these food items are top tier, because there's a lot of things that you can eat in this game that are way, like, not nearly as good. And these will be things like berries or mushrooms, anything you can pick, or even the basic meat items you can cook. And so for that, you have obviously regular meat, which you get from boars or deer. Then you have lox meat, which you get from lox, and that one's actually a pretty dang good food item. It's not as good as any of these ones, but as far as something that you can just kill them and cook it, you don't need any other ingredients, since it's really simple and you can do it at any level. Lox meat is the way to go. And then there's neck meat, which does very little. But these ones are going to be god-tier level food. So you eat these, it's going to give you a huge stamina boost, a huge health boost, and it's going to help you with healing. It's fantastic. So we're going to start off at number 6, and as you can see at number 6, we've already over here got it in the slot, sausages. So it says links of savory smoked meat. These ones have health, they add 60 health, 40 stamina. They last for 26 minutes, or 1600 seconds, and the healing that they do is 3 health points per tick. So your health will go up by 3 every time it ticks. Be that as it may, these are fantastic. So these ones you get, you can make them, you need intestines, meat, and nettles. Or thistles, not nettles, sorry. Thistles. And you can make them at your, well here, I'll just go show you. So once you have the ability to make your cauldron, you can cook at it. And one of the things you can make is sausages. And with that, you have entrails, raw meat, thistles. So those are the 3 items you need to make sausages. Once you have all that, you can make these, and they're very good. They stack up to 20, so that's another reason I like these, because a lot of the higher level stuff only stacks up to 10. Sausages go to 20, but they are very, very good. So that is number 6. Let's move on to number 5. And so at number 5, we have bread, and it says a tasty loaf of bread. Now for this one, you're going to need a windmill, so you'll have to build a windmill. It's, yeah, you unlock it relatively, well, as soon as you have a grinding wheel, you can make it. So I think you need to have iron tools, so you got to defeat second boss so you can get iron, and then you can make stone cutting stuff. And as soon as you can do that, you can make the stone cutting table, or you can make a grinding wheel. And for that, once you have that, you can make windmills, and then you can grind flour from barley, which you can either scavenge around the map, mostly in plains biomes, or you can grow it. And once you have that, you can bake bread. Whew, it's a lot of steps, but bread is a pretty good food item to have. It only stack, this one also stacks up to 20, so it's got that advantage over a lot of other stuff. It adds 40 health, 70 stamina, so it's a nice stamina boost. This one lasts 30 minutes, so you get a whole extra 4 minutes over the sausages. And this one is only 2 hit points per tick, so slightly slower than the last one, but definitely a good item. I don't use bread a lot just because I don't do a lot of farming, so I don't normally have a ton of flour. But when I have it, this is what I use it for, because, man, is bread good. So that's number 5. Let's move on to number 4. And so at number 4 we have fish wraps. And now this one's another one that's a little bit complicated to make. You're again going to need the ability to make barley flour, because it requires barley flour. So all the steps that I had for the bread, you need those two to make fish wraps. But you also need cooked fish. So the way to get cooked fish is, first of all, you need to find the trader, who will be randomly spawned around the map. Usually not on the island you spawn on, but on one of the islands right next to you. That's been my experience. I don't know if it's always that way, but anyway. You need to find the trader, and you need to have enough coins to buy a fishing pole and fishing bait from them. I have tried shooting them with bows out of the water, and I've never made it work, so I'm pretty sure you do need the fishing pole. Once you have that, you can obviously fish for your fish. It's best if you do it relatively close to shore, but not on shore. Off a raft or something. And you can, once you have fish, you cook them. And once you have the barley flour and the fish, you can make fish wraps. And these are, again, a pretty good one. Now, unfortunately, these only stack to 10, so they don't have that nice 20 stack. But they add 60 health, 90 stamina, so that's a hell of a stamina boost. In fact, I believe it's the best stamina boost on this list. So it's very, very good. They last 40 minutes, so that's a nice long boost. And that's how long the health and stamina will stay on your bar, I guess I should have said. And the healing rate is 4 health points per tick. So twice as fast as the bread. So like I said, fish wraps are the 4th best one. They're definitely a good item. And if you get annoyed by having to stop running, this is definitely a good one, because they give you the best stamina boost outside of meads, but we're not talking about mead today. So that's the fish wraps at number 4. Let's move on to number 3. So at number 3, we have blood pudding. And now, doesn't that sound delicious? It says it's bloody tasty, but, you know, not being an Englishman, I cannot say that I would agree with that. I don't think I would ever try it. But to make blood pudding, you need blood bags, thistles, and barley flour. So again, you're going to need barley flour, another reason to have a windmill, and blood bags, which you get from killing leeches from swamp biomes, and then thistles, which you can find in the Black Forest. Once you have all that, you can make blood pudding. And blood pudding is the highest health gainer out of any food item in the game. It'll give you 90 health, as you can see right there. You also get 50 stamina, which is a really good boost, and this one is another one that lasts 40 minutes, so it's a nice long time, and the healing is 4 health points per tick. So again, it's the same health points and duration as the fish wraps. So these two items, the fish wraps and the blood pudding, are going to be, the fish wraps give you the highest stamina boost, the blood pudding gives you the highest health boost. You put them together and you've got a heck of a boost. So that's blood pudding, which comes in at number 3. Let's move on to number 2. So at number 2, we have the lox meat pie. And now this one is going to require 3 items. You're going to, of course, need barley flour, which is obvious. You're going to also need lox meat, which you can get by killing those great big hairy beasts. Those are called lox. You kill those to get the meat. And lastly, you need cloud berries, which are these little golden berry clusters that you can find scattered across plains biomes. They're actually very, very common. Every plains biome I've ever been to has more of them than you could shake a stick at. So if you picture the meadow, how there's raspberries and blueberries all over the place, that's what the cloud berries are like in the plains biome. And I'm actually in a, if you don't know what a plains biome looks like, I'm in one right now. This is what a plains biome. You'd think it'd be a desert, but it's not. It's a plains. So this island I'm on is actually mostly plains. Once you get into there, you find the cloudberries, you get your lox meat, and lox also are a plains animal, so obviously you're going to need to come here to get the lox anyway. And of course, you need barley flour, so it's just a great one-stop shop. But this one is the second best one. This one has 80 health and 80 stamina, giving you a total for 160 points boosted. That's why I have this one ahead of the blood pudding, because even though it doesn't have as high of a health and it doesn't have as high of a stamina as the fish wraps, it's got 80 for both, so it's a heck of a boost. This one lasts 40 minutes and it's 4 hit points per tick, so definitely a ton of added health and stamina, and it helps you heal. Definitely a great item. I actually probably use this one more than a lot of the other ones on this list, mostly because it's easy to get lox meat, because there's lox all over the place, easy to get cloud berries, and I mean, you have to do the same amount of work for barley flour, but it's a little bit easier to get than like blood pudding, which you got to go hunt down leeches and they're kind of a pain. And fish wraps takes a lot of steps. So lox meat pie is number 2. Let's move on to the best one. So the best food item in the game is serpent stew. And for this one, you're going to need cooked serpent meat. So obviously you're going to need to kill serpents for this. So this is kind of a late game one for most people. You're also going to need honey. So it's best to just set up some beehives so you can constantly harvest honey. And then, of course, need mushrooms, just the plain red mushrooms, not the yellow ones. And, of course, those can be found in meadow biomes and, of course, Black Forest. So you need mushrooms, cooked serpent meat, and honey. And this one is, it has the same stats as the lox meat pie, 80 health, 80 stamina, lasts 40 minutes, and does 4 hit points per tick. I just put this one above it because, I don't know, it's stew and it seems a little bit more, I don't know why I did. They've got basically the same stats, but maybe I probably should have put lox meat pie above serpent stew because it's a little bit easier to make, but either way, they got the same stats. So what we're going to do is we're going to go god tier on you. So you want to see what it can look like if you just max out your health and stamina on this by at least for food consumption. Well, let's do it. So let's eat a blood pudding, a lox meat pie, and a serpent stew. And then let's take a peek at what it looks like when our health and stamina goes way the hell up. So you can see our stamina bar down on the bottom. Look how big that is. So when people ask me how I get my stamina so high, this is one of the ways. Well, I mean, this is the primary way. I'll also use mead, but food is the way I like to go because you don't have to wait for it to ferment. So let's just see how long it takes to max out our health. So there you have it. We've got 252 health, a ton of stamina. Look at that stamina. Look how slow that drains. You could run for days at this. So that's why it pays to have good food in this game. This is one game that really rewards you for unlocking the ability to make better food and making it and taking it with you. Because if you thought eating some berries and some cooked meat was giving you a heck of a boost, check out that boost. So that's why I made this guide. I wanted to help all of you figure that out. So I told you how to do each item, where to get the stuff, etc., etc. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope it was useful. But in any case, thanks for watching and have a nice day. And we'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching another Dare to Game video. If you liked this video, please leave a like and a comment. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to the channel. If you like my content and would like to support this channel, consider becoming a member today for as little as $1.99 a month. It makes a huge difference. But in any case, thanks for watching and have a nice day. I'll see you next time.